Hey guys, it's Spaulding here, and today I'm bringing you the second video of our series What is the Correct Play? And in the first video, in the introduction video, I discussed a sequence over multiple turns from Fire Nature Rush. And yeah, for any other deck where your turns will most likely go beyond turn 4 or 5, this will get like really complicated, because you have to assume at some point your opponent is interacting with you, and there are so many possibilities. So I decided that for this video and for also for the next videos, we will just go over like one turn and discuss the decisions there, and just leave it like that. So these videos will only last like a couple of minutes. Yeah, and this time we are playing Rug Aggro or Fire Water Nature Aggro. If you're not familiar with which cards you play in the stack, feel free to check out our channel, where you will find a Fire Water Nature deck profile, which won one of the IDC tournaments. I think IDC 2 it was. So yeah, let's just jump right into it. What is the correct play? And of course we have only one decision to make in turn 1, because we can't play something at turn 1 and we can't attack with something on turn 1. So the only decision here is what to charge in mana. We don't know what our opponent is playing. This is game 1, we are starting. What should you charge? And just pause the video and think about the decision, and I will give you the answer right now. The answer is we charge Searing Wave. We want to charge a fire or a nature mana turn 1, and this is because this deck plays 4 copies of Gonta. And if you would have charged Aqua Surfer turn 1 and then top deck a Gonta the next turn, then you would be really sad, because you can't play it because you charged a water mana. Of course, Aggro Surfer, if you don't play Gonta, is the weakest card in the hand. You will most likely never cast it, or at least you have to get to 6 mana to cast it, so you can just charge it in mana. If you don't top deck Gonta the next turn, then on turn 2 you charge Aggro Surfer, but in the first turn you always charge a nature or a fire mana. So why Searing Wave over Arc and over Magnus? Well, Arc is a really good blowout card when your opponent is playing Darkness and is playing something like Locomotive, Cranium Clamp, even later in the game Lost Soul, or even Ghost Touch or Clone Nightmare. And because we don't know what our opponent is playing yet, we want to keep the Arc in our hand. If our opponent charges something next turn and we know he isn't playing Darkness, then we can freely charge it next turn. So no Arc charge in the first turn. Why no Magnus? Well, Magnus goes really well with Arc, because Magnus is really hard to answer, because it gets bounced back to your hand at the end of your turn, and your opponent will or has to discard Magnus or rely on a shield trigger to kill him, which is of course not reliable. And so he wants to discard it from your hand, and if he hits Arc, well, you most likely win the game. So that's why Searing Wave is the correct play to charge on turn 1. Of course, next turn when we draw Gonta, we have to charge Arc, because we want a green mana to cast Gonta, and the turn after that we most likely charge the Aqua Surfer to play Holkus on turn 3. So really short video, I hope you guys liked it. Feel free to check out our channel for more Duel Masters content, and see you in the next video.